Nine Inch Nails changed the landscape of industrial rock and metal with the release of their 1994 album, The Downward Spiral. This week marked the 25th anniversary of the album's release, and in celebration, we're going to dig deep into this monster recording. This is Frank from Metal Injection counting down 25 facts about The Downward Spiral that you may not know. Although the album is commercially known for a song that features the memorable phrase, "I wanna fuck you like an animal," the album is a diverse masterpiece and concept album that follows its protagonist, Mr. Self-Destruct, through his downward spiral of drugs, depression, violence, sex, and ultimately suicide. When developing the album, Trent struggled with a dark time of addiction. The record not only notes Trent's personal issues of his own downward spiral, but emphasizes the mood and textures of his chaotic mindset during this time. The album was recorded in the house where actress Sharon Tate was murdered by the Manson family in 1969. Trent Reznor spent 18 months living in this house, also recording the Broken EP, as well as Marilyn Manson's Portrait of an American Family at this location. Reznor called the house studio where the album was recorded "Le Pig," referencing the message that was written on the front door in Tate's blood. In December of 1993, Trent was confronted by Sharon Tate's sister, asking if he was exploiting her murder. The encounter caused Trent to cry and see things from a different perspective, knowing it was something he didn't support. Reznor moved out of the house after the recording, and it was demolished shortly after. You can see the very studio house where the album was recorded from the music video "Gave Up," found on the band's 1992 Broken EP. Much of the music was recorded using brand new technology for the time, namely Pro Tools software on a Macintosh computer. With this equipment, Trent captured, then digitally rearranged freeform performances to create new sounds. Then he converted them back into analog tape. Trent's work became revolutionary to music itself and helped both Pro Tools and Macintosh become leading powers in the music business. Artist Russell Mills created the cover art for The Downward Spiral, a multimedia piece he calls Wound, made from plaster, acrylics, oils, rusted metals, insects, moths, blood, wax, and bandaging on a wooden panel. Given the nature of the lyrics and power of the music, Mills had stated, "I wanted to make beautiful surfaces that partially reveal the visceral rawness of an open wound." When speaking about The Downward Spiral, Reznor has stated, "I wanted it to be a departure from Broken, where I wanted to make a real hard-sounding record that was just one big blast of anger." The album opens with a sample taken from George Lucas's 1971 film, THX-1138. The main inspiration for the album was David Bowie's 1977 release, Low, an experimental album that touched Trent for songwriting and structures. The iconic drum sample found on the single Closer is originally a bass and drum sample from Iggy Pop's track Nightclubbing off his 1977 debut album. The single version of the track Closer is 13 seconds longer than the one found on the album, which was cut down to segue into the track Ruiner. The music video for Closer was directed by Mark Romanek, who was known at the time for working with acts like Madonna, David Bowie, and Lenny Kravitz. Needless to say, his work on Closer ushered in a new edgy style for this director. The main inspiration for the music video Closer was a 21-minute long stop animation film called Street of Crocodiles, released in 1986. Trent Reznor performed the drums on the track Piggy, making it the only live drum performance of his own on the album. During the track Reptile, you can find an audio sample of a woman falling down a hill. It's taken from the 1974 film The Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Big Man with a Gun was a subject of controversy when the lyrics were cited by conservatives William Bennett and C. Dolores Tucker during their crusade against explicit lyrics in rap and hip-hop, mislabeling Nine Inch Nails as one of these acts. Trent Reznor has gone on record to say he somewhat regrets including the song Big Man with a Gun, stating, "If he had more time, I probably would have not put that song on the record, just because I don't think it's a good song, not because I got spanked for it." The song The Becoming includes a sample from the 1989 obscure film Robot Jocks, a movie about a post-World War III time when war is outlawed. The song Hurt was recorded at A&M Studios in Room B, while Bob Seger was recording there, but away on Christmas break. The vocals were recorded in a complete take with no comps through a Shure SM Beta 58, so he can connect intimately with the lyrics of the song. Reznor would later agree to let Johnny Cash record the song as one of his final releases, which took the world by storm for its sincere and bleak take on the track that served as a poetic goodbye to a music legend. Producer Flood, real name Mark Ellis, has worked on many legendary Dark albums, including early Ministry, Nick Cave and the Bad Seeds, Depeche Mode, U2, and the previous two Nine Inch Nails releases. Despite the great run, The Downward Spiral marks the last album Flood produced for Nine Inch Nails, for apparent creative differences during the process. The Self-Destruct tour included a stop at Woodstock 94, where the band showed up completely covered in mud from a playful fight before they took the stage, and went on to completely steal the show. The Downward Spiral was a huge success, launching Nine Inch Nails into a worldwide commercial act, which made Trent Reznor an uneasy megastar, eventually plunging him into years of self-loathing and destruction, making the album somewhat of a self-fulfilling prophecy. And that's our list. Tell us what you think in the comments below, and be sure to subscribe to Metal Injection for more updates.